Hi, my name is Hannah, and I'm so very glad that you found this video that is about this clue book that is called an EN MASSE journal or EN MASSE clue book. And I haven't shown it in any videos before. I just made it and I really wanted to show it to you. So that's what we're doing today. As you can see, this is quite a big notebook. It is the size of A4, and this is a composition notebook, so you can compare these sizes. And this is one I've been doing some videos on. It is my color glue book or rainbow glue book, where each section that I marked off with tape is a color that I'm cutting out from magazines and filling on that theme. So this is like teal and turquoise, so that's how this one is working. And I did this together with my mom. She has a slightly smaller version of this and she's filling her. She's almost done, I'm almost done. And when we were ready to move on, I found another project on YouTube that is called an EN MASSE journal or glue book. So I introduced the idea to my mom and she was all in and ready to dive in to make one of her own. So I found simple notebooks. They're not even notebooks, they're like paper pads that we got like they're from like when you go to a conference and they're like handing you paper to take notes on. So that's what this was from the beginning. And then I covered mine with some papers and mom did the same on hers. And it's just scrapbook papers on the front and the back. And I printed a Hello Kitty that I cut up and used as my front. Added some holographic glittery duct tape to the spine, and then I had some overhead papers, you know, those plastic sheets that you use when you're showing stuff at school in the olden days. I doubt they do that these days when they have computers hooked up to the ceiling, but anyway, I had some of those overhead plastic sheets. And I sewed all around, so it's really protected and shiny and beautiful. So I did it on both sides, and I'm going to clean this up. It's gotten some glue on it, but it will be fine because I can just wipe it down later on. So that's the cover. Then we cut out some tabs. I have like a punchy that does this shape, and just added in one for each page. I added mine to the side and mom put hers on the top because she liked that look better. But they're just simple shapes, and I just glued one bit and added them to each side. And then we went to town cutting out images, and it is so fun. I'm going to, if you want to look at the video of my rainbow glue book, an introduction talking about how you can start one of these, I have a video on that. And I now want to talk about how you can get started on this kind of project. So I'll introduce you to the cover and what I did. But first, just let me tell you what a EN MASSE book is. I will be linking down below Shannon Green, who is the inventor of the title of EN MASSE journals, and Carla, I think her name is, of Caged Fish, who made a similar project, but she called hers something else. I will glue you to those ladies. I will link you to those ladies below, and then from their videos it's taken off, and Everyone who likes glue books has probably done one already. I'm late, as it is, but anyway. And basically, what you do is pick a notebook, or like a brochure or anything that is about the size that you want to use, and then you just start picking themes. You can make a list on the side. While you're going through magazines, you will also find that, oh, there are a lot of flowers in these kind of magazines that I have. And then you can do flower as a theme, or you can do roses or just pink flowers or whatever theme you want to like hone in on. So it's really fun because it shows your taste. My first single page is going to be patterns. So I always cut out patterns from magazines. And these are some stickers as well as some papers printed and I think, yeah, some scrapbook paper. But anyway, otherwise these are the background of interior design magazines. So this is a wallpaper, and this one is a wallpaper, and this is a piece of a sofa in like an ad. So any pattern goes, and all it has to do is like speak to me personally. So that's the patterns I cut out. So from the pictures I kind of cut out, I find little bits of those patterns, make a little square, and I'm going to be continuing on and adding in until it's all filled. And I think Shannon has a list of themes, but I'm not interested in doing other people's themes. So I've done my own thing with the things that I like. Some might be the same. I haven't really checked her list. I've just been looking for pictures, and I've talked a lot about frogs in the past. So I have a collection of frog images. And basically, all that you do is you collect a lot of images of the same thing, and then you cover the whole spread with those things. So this will be my frog spread. You don't really need to source out any particular paper. A paper pad is just fine. Like this one has lined paper, and that's just, it's just fine because it's not fine art or anything. It's just for doing and having fun, and it's super fun once all the pictures come together and you glue them in. I was thinking of doing a page on armchairs, but then I also added in sofas. So just soft, comfortable chairs. So this is going here. I've added into this spread. And I'll, again, it's just my preferences. I'm just cutting out chairs that speak to me, that I like. I wouldn't mind having any of these in my home. And this was like an ad where they had lots on the same page, so I thought it was a good background for these chairs. So, and I mean this one, oh my goodness, I really want this chair. Velvety pink and yellow and brown. So yummy. Or an egg chair. Well, who wouldn't want one of those if you had the room for it? So this is my page. Then we're going into drinks, and it's a work in progress, but I wanted to show you that you can pick, like when you find this image, and then after you browse a little bit and you find this image and you know you really like these two, you know you have a theme that you can build on and that you can kind of keep looking for images that fits into those kind of themes. So these are yummy drinks, some smoothies, some alcohol drinks, some juice, some wine, sparkling wine perhaps. I think it's just super yummy to put them all together and see what fits. And then we go to the cat page. I love this page. I love cats, so of course I had to have a cat page. And this entire thing just makes me happy. And this is really fun because some of these pictures, like this one with a cat in a fishbowl and this little kitten, is from my teenage cutout folders that I haven't really used in a long time. I mean, I glue a lot of stuff into my art journals and I have inspiration glue books and stuff, but for some reason these have been laying around for, I don't know, 25, 30 years. So it was really fun to just go through my folder of animals and decide to finally glue those kittens and images down and use them. So of course you can't really tell which of these images I've been hoarding, but I can, and that makes it special to me. And then I had a sheet of big stickers, so this is a sticker from that sheet, as well as this kitten and these ones and that one, that just fitted perfectly with this theme. So, and then I couldn't help myself, added in some wild cats as well, and this just because it's funny, a rowing boat cat. I love the cinema cat with his popcorns and 3D glasses. He's so cute. I'm super surprised to be in this project. But I love this entire spread so, so much. So this is what an en masse journal is. And I have cats left over, so no worries. I can use cats in my art journal in the future, and I will source out new cat images, I'm sure. But this is a super fun way to use images that you have a lot of, or that you can find a lot of if you're looking. We have been looking through so many, and I haven't written on my labels yet, but I will. We have been looking through so many magazines, Mom and me, through the past couple of days. So this is my dog page, as you might have guessed. And Mom had a whole pack of like tiny, tiny stickers. And it was so fun to just add in as many as we could on the side. And I added in a puppy here so that you can find the puppy page. And yeah, I just love all of these fuzzy furry friends. They are so cute. This is my eye page, and I'm going to do a little video on eyes, so I'm not going to talk too much about this. Just going to skip on. This is fun, colorful fashion girls. Kind of hard to find fashion girls that has some colorful outfits. A lot of them are wearing gray or brown or beige or blue. I don't know. But I found these and I love all of them. A lot of these are from this magazine. It's an L companion book that was like a trend bible 2015. So I love the images in this one. So a lot of colorful and fun images in just this one image, in this just one magazine. Hands is a theme that I have, so I'm gonna use this image. Eyes, so many eyes. I love this layout. And this is the kind of magazine image that I was talking about. It's a perfect background image. It's a perfect for finding patent papers. Love this embroidery. Love these that are grouped after colors. They would be perfect for like your color glue book. But this is what I mean. I mean, most of the fashion in these kind of magazines are these bits. But you'd be very happy when you find something like that. Totally yellow. And her, she can go in my spread here. So I just wanted to, before I cut this up entirely, because I will. I absolutely love all of these images. They will go in here. So I will continue on to that page. Then I did houses, which is not really aesthetically appealing to me like a page, but I really like each of the images. So that's what I'm taking away from this. And I think it's fun that there are different kinds of houses. So this is maybe architecture. There's a castle, there's townhouse, there are country houses, there's a birdhouse. So lots of different kind of spaces to live in. And if you're doing eyes, of course you will be also be cutting out the mouth of all those models that you are cutting out the eyes of. So that's kind of a given theme. And going back to my youth, when I was starting my career as a cut and paste girl, I was 13 or 14 when I made my first mouth collage. So that's really fun to remember that and just be that girl again. So this is kind of done. I don't think I can fit any more fruit into this page, but I love how it came together. So let's see, this is one image. But then I added this and that and kind of fruits on top and over the borders. So it's kind of built in fruit table. And I just want to go and have a bowl of fruit when I see this. I love this page so much. And then we have some pages that I've not started yet. Yes, coffee I've started. And this is going to be vases. And I'm thinking of doing hard shares. I don't know what it's called in English. I have to look it up. Men pinstol in Swedish. So that was the theme. Mom's doing quilts, so I thought I'd do that too, with some fun fabric images. Words and sentences. And I decided to exclude my English sentences and just go for Swedish on this page. So that's what you're seeing. Lots of things. And I'm not just cutting out all the words. I'm cutting out things that are speaking to me, that feels like they're interesting or saying something about the time or my life in some way. So that's that page. Flowers, haven't started. Clouds, almost done. Just a little bit here that needs to go. And this is not even clouds, it's sky now, because I wanted to include this one where some stars or planets, I'm not sure, has been marked out, but I don't mind. So, cloud porn, kind of. And I'm going to be doing a page on toys. I have another folder of more toys. And we'll see how it looks in the end. I kind of save them like this, just to know where they are. And then I lay them out and see if there is one big image that doesn't fit, I move it aside. And then I kind of try to make a puzzle before I start gluing them down. Because if you just glue without a plan, it's a lot harder. And I do this a lot, kind of lets it hang over the edge of the page so that I can align it properly without having a paper cutter out. So that's that, and you can maybe perhaps guess what kind of theme this is. And a lot of these images are from my youth too. I don't know, I don't want to use any Disney images in my art or art journals because they're so strict with copyright. But in a page like this, where it's just the theme of animation, I think I could use some of them, and I had a lot. I obviously love animation and cartoons. I don't know if you say cartoon, but feature films that features animated characters. I'd love that. So there's a lot on this page, and I love how colorful and happy and eclectic is this. Love it. I could fit some more in if I find some smaller images, I'm sure. So I'm not saying it's totally done, I'm just saying it is, I'm happy with it right now. So I could keep on adding probably to all of these pages. Here is my book page. Love this page so, so much. Came together really quickly because it's just mainly big images. But I also added in an open book. And some smaller bits on top where like the article was. Love this page. And I mean, if you love books, I'm sure you can understand why I like it so much. Love, love, love. I love libraries, I love bookshops, I love reading. So of course, I had to include books. More stuff that is not finished yet. And I was thinking of shelves for this, but I haven't found much, so I might change my mind. That's why also why I haven't glued these down. I don't have enough, and I might change my mind and do another theme. So this is the frogs, and then it's the last page where we have a little pocket that I sewed in when I did these. Sewed them to the cover, And this idea I got from a YouTuber called Melanie Sullivan, so which I've been binge watching because I love her composition journals. You have to go and see. She had a tutorial or like a talk on how she does her covers. I will link her channel. She has a lot of videos. You can go and fall in love with her if you want to. But that is a glue EN MASSE glue book. And EN MASSE just means a lot of. So a lot of clouds, a lot of images, a lot of coffee. Who doesn't like love to have their coffee standing by when they're making glue books? So that is what I wanted to talk about. And I think if you have a folder of collage images, you can go through it and see if you find any themes that you're already cutting out stuff of a lot. I mean, I always cut out anything that is colorful or patterned. All animals I see. So I already had half of these cats in my folder of animals. So before we even started working on these pages, I found this stashed in between some other images. So I've already thought of the idea of doing a lot of these kind of things, but never in one journal that is dedicated just to EN MASSE. But I really love it. I love this journal so much, and I can't wait to continue working in it and to see if this is an idea that you want to go with and try out. I would love to see it. Tag me on Instagram. Go watch more videos of this kind of ideas. And make your own list of themes that you want to start collecting on. So that's all I had for today. Oh, and I just wanted to mention that, we thought it was so much fun to do these edges that I did in my rainbow journal. I decided to do all pink in this one, just to get the pages started or decorated a bit. A roll of shimmery paper borders that I have. So I've just used this one a lot, and then I used some of the holographic tape, but that wasn't that great because my tabs are not holding fast, so I'll just have to secure them in another way than the glue stick. But yeah, just to get us going with decorating the pages, we both added in these kind of finishes to the edges. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching this video, giving it a thumbs up and subscribing if you haven't already. And leave me a comment if this is something that you think you want to try, or if you have done it already, and what your favorite theme is. Mine is definitely the colorful ones, fruits and Disney animated characters and the drinks. Yeah, I love the drink page because it surprised me. I haven't cut out many drinks and I don't like food images, but I love this. It makes me thirsty. I'm going to go fix a drink now. Thank you again, and don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Oh, and also while you're here, click on over to my blog in case you want to see more images, read more, check out more about this project. Thanks. Bye.